So you come home from work and discover the mangled remains of your hardware wallet as it's been chewed up by your dog. And you panic because there's a bull run on at the moment. You want to do some trades, but you realize there's a 3-month back order on getting a new hardware wallet. What can you do? How can you access your funds? Don't panic. Fortunately, it's easier and quicker than you might think. And that's what we're going to look at today. So if you haven't already done so, hit subscribe to be kept in the loop about future content I make that helps you to find your way in the crazy and often hostile space that is cryptocurrency. A number of crypto wallets out there use a common standard now, which means if your hardware wallet is lost or destroyed, or even if the company that made it goes out of business, you can simply use one of these other wallets that uses the same standard to regain access to your funds. There are some important advantages as well as risks that go along with doing this, and I've included all of them in the description, because when you restore your seed phrase into a software wallet like this, you're actually losing one of the key bits of protection that a hardware wallet gives you. So it can be a great solution as a stopgap if you're wanting to access funds and move them in a hurry, but really not a good idea to just use this as a cheap way to have access to all of the funds on your hardware wallet on your mobile phone as well. Generally speaking, using something like Coinomi on your phone to access your funds like this can be a really good balance of security and convenience, in that a non-rooted, up-to-date phone is generally a much more secure environment than the normal desktop that you use day-to-day and any software or wallet you're likely to run on there. All right, so we've downloaded Coinomi off the Google Play Store. So we've clicked Restore Wallet, and now we just enter our seed phrase, just like we would with a Ledger or a Trezor. If you'd used a BIP39 passphrase to add security to your 24-word seed, you need to enter that too. It might have been referred to as a 25th word, depending on your wallet provider. This isn't the PIN that you use to access your wallet. This isn't the password you use to access Ledger Live or anything else like that. Even if you're just using this for temporary recovery, it is worth adding a short password on here, just so that your password is encrypted in the app itself and is only ever decrypted when you go to send funds. So unlike Ledger Live or Trezor, you actually need to tell Coinomi which cryptocurrencies you had before it will list them in there for you. So we'll say Bitcoin. We also have Bitcoin Cash. We have some Ethereum. We had Horizon. And we had Litecoin. Now, before we go any further, if you get to this screen here, where you've added in your 24-word seed, you've added in your passphrase, and you've added in your coins, and everything has a balance of zero, you're wondering where your coins are, don't panic. You've probably just made a typo in your BIP39 passphrase. Your 24-word seed will generally tell you if what you're trying to enter is invalid or if it has an error, but your BIP39 passphrase has no error checking whatsoever. Even a single character error in your BIP39 passphrase will come up and show you a whole bunch of empty wallets rather than give you some kind of error message. So it's finished adding all the accounts, and we can see that it's found a grand total of about 4.59 USD. While it's found most of the cryptocurrencies, the totals for each one don't actually match what we expect from Ledger Live. And the reason for that is that some of these accounts that we had, because they were legacy, because they were SegWit, native SegWit, split and unsplit, will be on derivation paths that Coinomi isn't expecting. So we need to manually add those coin types and manually tell it what derivation path to look for. So for example, we'll just use Bitcoin Cash, because we can see here that it's found the split Bitcoin Cash, but it hasn't found this small amount of unsplit Bitcoin Cash, because it's still sitting on basically the old Bitcoin derivation path. So I'll just show you how to do that. So what we're gonna do is just select plus on the main account summary screen, and we're gonna say add coins. We are going to select Bitcoin Cash, and what we're going to click on is the little spanner just to the right. We'll just give it a name, the same name as it has in Ledger Live, just so we don't get confused. Bitcoin Cash 1, unsplit. And we are going to say advanced. And so we're basically just going to copy this information over here, which is listed under fresh address path, and we are going to put that into the derivation path. We want everything basically that has an apostrophe next to it in terms of the numbers. So we are just going to say m/44?/0?/0?, and then we're just going to say okay. Once we're done, we can just say plus, and then it's going to ask for our account password. And now once it's finished adding the account, we can see that this Bitcoin and Cash 1 is now there, and the two transactions that we're expecting to see are there, so it's now showing correctly. The other really big difference that you need to know about with Coinomi is the way that it represents different accounts for the same currency that use a different address format. If you're using Ledger Live or Trezor and hold Bitcoin, you might have it in accounts that are created using the legacy address format. You might have some using the SegWit address format, and you might have some using native SegWit format. And Ledger Live represents each of those separately. Whereas what you can see here is that Coinomi actually represents them all together. So it will actually bundle the first SegWit, the first legacy, and the first native SegWit account for Bitcoin and represent them as a single account. So what it's doing here is it's actually lumping together these first three Bitcoin accounts and representing them as one account. But at the same time, it hasn't found the second legacy account for Bitcoin that I have. And like with Bitcoin Cash, I'll need to add that in manually. Though because this Bitcoin is just using the standard derivation paths, I don't need to do anything special other than select Bitcoin, hit the blue button, and add my account password. And it will add the second Bitcoin account and find the balance of this Bitcoin 2 account. If you've seen my previous video on locating lost Ethereum, you'd be aware that the older versions of the Ledger Ethereum app and current versions of the Coinomi app actually store Ethereum on a different derivation path from just about every other wallet out there. So while Coinomi has automatically found what Ledger Live calls the legacy wallet, it hasn't found what is the sort of current derivation path format that Ledger Live uses. So if we do the same thing we did with Bitcoin Cash, go into the account that's missing, click on the spanner and go into advanced logs, we can see the derivation path we want there, and we just need to do the same process we did for Bitcoin Cash. So we click the plus, say we want to add a coin, we want to add Ethereum, and we're going to click on the spanner. We'll call this the same thing as in Ledger Lives. Now what we're going to do for Ethereum is a little bit different to what we did with Bitcoin Cash, just because of the way Ethereum handles change. So we're actually going to enter in the derivation path down to the fourth number. So we're just going to say m/44?/60?/0?/0. We're going to say okay. Then we put plus to in the password. And there you go. We can see that once it's finished adding it, it has found the Ethereum that we wanted. And again, if you're coming from Trezor or any other platform like that, the derivation path I used just then is probably exactly the one that you want. And you'll need to manually increment that to add additional accounts if that's how you'd been using your Ethereum. You can also just add ERC20 tokens into Coinomi in much the same way as you add currencies, and you basically just click the little blue thing, say add token. You have to select the blockchain that you want, but you also have to select the account that they were coming from. So this is the Ethereum address that those ERC20 tokens were associated with. And then basically you can either just add well-known tokens, or you may need to add a token manually by its smart contract address. So basically, if you find your token that you want on Etherscan, so for example, we've got USDT, Tether, and if you scroll down to profile summary, it has the contract and the decimals. And you can just enter in the contract address there, enter in the decimals there, and just add whatever name or symbol you like. And then just say add ERC20 token and you're done. So there you go. So you can see now we've found all the different accounts that we had in Ledger Live, and they're all now represented in Coinomi. So you can easily now just use Coinomi to send those funds onto your new wallet, and you'll be good to go. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Hit like if you think that other people would find this video useful, and hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make that helps people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. If you have any questions about this video or a topic that you'd like me to cover, just leave a reply.